A typical web page is made up of three separate layers that work together to deliver an experience to the user. There's a content layer, or the information you see on the page, a presentation layer that handles how that information looks, and a behavior layer that lets users interact with that page. CSS, or cascading style sheets, provides the presentation layer and creates the visual style of web pages using colors, typography, layout, and more. The behavior layer is handled by JavaScript to add interactivity to the page. For example, popping up a larger image when a user clicks a small image. HTML, or hypertext markup language, provides the content layer and forms the structural foundation of a web page. It's the language common to every website. So if you want to build your own website, web application, or know how to edit other websites and apps, you'll need to understand HTML. I'm Gil, your front-end web development teacher here at Treehouse. Your journey into learning code begins here with HTML basics. You may have already worked with HTML or seen it in action in a previous course. So in this course, we're going to dive deeper into many of the core concepts of HTML. So first, let's break down the meaning of the initialism HTML, hypertext markup language. Hypertext is any text that can be displayed on a computer screen and contains links to other texts, or hypertext documents. The web is a collection of billions of documents interconnected by hyperlinks. For example, the page you're viewing right now is a hypertext document, and you most likely clicked on a hyperlink to get to this page. A markup language provides meaning to text in a document using instructions that describe how text should be structured, formatted, and laid out. So HTML is a markup language the browser uses to present information to users, like text, links, images, and videos. It's the basic component from which all websites and applications on the web are built. Let's quickly review how HTML works, what it looks like, and why we use it to structure content on the web. If you've worked with a word processing program, like Microsoft Word or Google Docs, you've likely formatted blocks of plain text by creating a title for the document and headings to indicate the start of important sections of content. Also, adjusting the size of text and making it bold so that it stands out from other text. You may have inserted links to other documents or web pages, or you've inserted line breaks, spaces, and horizontal lines to divide and break up sections of content. In other words, you used the program's formatting options to give the document a clear structure. HTML provides similar text formatting instructions to browsers in the form of tags called markup. So just like a Word or Google document with no formatting would look like this, a web page without HTML tags or markup would look like this. Now here's the same content displayed in the browser using markup. Notice the text on the page is easier to scan and understand, and it provides links to navigate to other pages and more content. If I right or control click on the page and click View Page Source, I'm able to see the HTML the browser uses to display this simple web page. Now, take a look at the sets of tags that surround the content. That's the markup responsible for displaying this page. And notice how, even though these tags are meant as instructions for the browser, they're named using friendly, human-readable words like title, body, header, main, and footer. HTML is understood by all browsers, from browsers on phones to tablets to desktop computers. That's why every website and web app you use is made using HTML. It's the language of the web, and I'm going to teach you how to write it. By the end of this course, you'll have learned the skills to create the HTML structure of a simple website about virtual reality, like this. And as I mentioned before, HTML is just part of what makes a website. Adding a bit of CSS can transform the structure of a page into something beautiful, like this. So let's get started.